Hey guys, welcome back. So guys, we are continuing our React.js e-commerce series with Laravel API. So guys, now as we saw in previous video, we have done with our collections where we have viewed all the collection data. Okay, men, mobile, and etc. If you add on, it will get viewed. Okay, so guys, now let's click here on this mobile and we'll go on this collection slash mobile, right? So for this, we need to create the route and get the products data over here. Okay, so guys, let's get started. So before that, you can see this error, right? Can't perform React state on unmounted component. Okay, so this will leak your unnecessary data, memory data. Okay, so it shows this warning. So guys, for that you need to just set something mounted things. So first let's go to this collection, that is your category page. Let's go in your React app. So view category. So this is our view category page, guys, and this is our user effect. So inside this, create one let, and is mounted is equal to true. And then if you are setting any data, so give if condition, open and close, control X, paste. Okay, this mounted will be checked over here until unless you are setting data, that you are going to do. And in this use effect, we have a cleanup function, that is we do by return, open and close, arrow function, where you can tell is mounted is equal to false, save, and let's refresh, go to home page, refresh. And now let's go to collection. So you can see there is no any error. So let's move to contact. No error. Let's get back to collection. Perfect, guys. So now let's begin with this, our view product. So let's get back. Let's create one file, guys, inside our collections folder called viewproduct.js. Okay. Hit enter, create a function. So now let's call this page. So we'll move to our public route, create the path. Okay, let me paste. So guys, this will be my path collection slash colon slug. Okay, so this colon slug means we are going to pass any other data, like under collections you are passing that after that slug, right? So that slug we are passing over here. The name will be view product, component also will be view product. So let's import that path, import from this path, guys. Where is that our file? Here it is, view product. Okay, front end collection, that one. So just call the correct path, save. And now guys, let's see the output for this. Return open and close function, where I'll start with h4 tag, product, save. And you can see, guys, the page is called. Perfect. So let's begin with designing our product view and get the product data according to our categories of your product. Okay, so let's get back. So first we will design our form, guys. So let's copy from our view category to save time. Let's get back. Let's copy the same and paste it. Done. Category forward slash and your product name. So prod name will give right now. We will just change that after that. So right now we don't have our product list should show, but we'll create the variable product list. Let's comment this, save, and see the output. Refresh. Cool. So category and here our product list will be shown. Let's get back. Start with the use effect to get the data, guys. So use effect. So now guys, let's create the loading part first. Use state, where we'll tell loading, and make this to capital L, set loading, where we are going to make it true. Let's give this over here. If else loading return H4 will tell loading products done. And now inside use effect you are going to start. So first let's mount this guys. So let is mounted is equal to true and copy this. Under this cleanup we are going to make it to false. So as same as we made for our category thing right now. Okay, so keep this and make it to false in your return. That's it guys. So spelling mistake, let's keep that in a correct mounted. Now guys let's write a code to get the data. So first axios, so import the class, done. Axios dot you're going to get the data, so use get function, then response of your if this mount is set true then only you can get all the data. Response dot data dot status triple equal to 200 when it is success means you will get the data. Okay, so what data you are going to get and set that. So let's get that set product. Okay, so first step guys let's create that over here. Let's copy this set product over here and this will be your array format to store the data and make this to product. That's it guys. And now response dot data dot your product data will be here, done. So let's parse that product data, all your products. Okay, so same way we need to get the category data also. Copy and paste and make this to category and tell from here product data you will get category also. Okay, let's create one more state for the category, set category, and this will be a category value. Done guys. And now guys if the condition is wrong, like if the product is not found, so for that let's create a status of 404. Response dot data dot status is triple equal to 404 which we want to redirect back to collections page. Okay, so history dot push where you will tell single quotes forward slash. Okay, and after this I want to show a message, so swal swal which is sweet alert guys. Please import that class and open and close function where you will tell as we don't have this product as warning comma response dot data dot message whatever we send from there, let's show that as error icon. Okay, as error message. And now guys we are using history, so you need to pass this under this. Okay, and create one variable history is equal to use history. Okay, function, and you're going to import the history class guys. That's it, done. And now let's create the API. So use backtick forward slash API forward slash will tell fetch products ducts and we want the category ID like this your collection slash mobile. So we need this mobile data, right? So how can you get that? So your parameter value. So let me just create a variable with const product slug. Okay, so that is our slug where props dot match dot parents dot slug semicolon. Okay, So you are using props. Let's send that inside this function view product. Set guys, and now let's take this product slug and send by the URL. Give forward slash dollar open and close curly brace and send your product slug. That's it, guys. So now let's copy this route or API and create that in our Laravel application. So let's get back to a Laravel app. So under api.php, create a route, guys. So let me just done. Fetch product forward slash curly brace and in that slug. So this is our route, guys, and go to your front end controller at product. Okay, so let's copy this and go to your front end controller and create a function. So public function with the product function name, and now let's get that slug dollar slug slug. Okay, so this slug is coming from your URL which you are passing inside this function. And now guys, let's create one variable called category is equal to, where you will check the category data first. So category colon colon where you are going to tell slug comma dollar slug, where you will check that product is available or not. So status of 0 with the first. Okay, so you can get the data also from this. Let's use if condition. If category is available, then you will get the products. If the category is not there, like that. Okay, so for that case, guys, you are going to return and response the 404 status. So let's paste. Done, guys. So no such product found, no such category found. And let's get back here. If the product is found, guys, if the category is found, then you're going to get the product's detail. So product is equal to your product model colon colon where open and close function. And now guys, from this you're going to, from your product table, you're going to get category underscore ID. So which means your this one. So under your product table, your category underscore ID. So that data you are going to get. Give comma where dollar category. So this category, okay, dollar category of ID, you're going to check where the same status. If the product is there, means you are going to get using get function to get the data. So guys, now let's take this in a if condition. If product is present, means you will show the data, else you will tell no record for, okay, no product available for that category. Let's give else condition and pass. So let's copy this, guys, and paste over here. Under this we'll tell 400 request, any bad request and all. So you can tell no product available. Okay, if the product is there, then guys, you need to return the data. So let me just copy and paste over here, and which will be success, that is 200. And the instead of message we have given in our React app, when it is 200, that time you will see one product data variable. So let's get that, paste here product data variable and send that in a array format. So let's open and close array. Inside this, let's give product open and close the dollar product, send it, copy and paste, and this will be your category, and copy this category data. That's it, guys. So now with this help of data and all, we are going to fetch in our React app. As you can see, category and product. Okay, so make sure your spelling is correct, guys. Let's copy this and paste here. Perfect. So let's give else if again over here, and copy this, paste, and show that 401. Okay, so if there is no product such like that, so you can show that message warning as no product available, and so save. And now guys, let's get this data from set product. So let's copy this product and go below inside your loading condition, if condition, in the else part. Let's create a variable where of your what you have given here, show product list is equal to null, and this show product list is equal to your state. So which state? Product state. Copy this product state and paste. Use a map function to loop the data where you will tell item and your auto incremented any ID X. Open and close, curly brace. Let me just clear this. So guys, now you need to return function and design a card, guys. So this is our row. Let's take in a div of column 3, class name. So let me finish this design, guys. So guys, this is our design now. And yep guys, so first let's fetch the image. So let's remove this double quotes and give open and close curly brace with the backtick. Let's call our hosted path like this one. Okay, so Laravel application path, let's call that, paste, give dollar open and close curly brace, where you will tell item of dot your database image field name. So you can find that image image it is. Okay, so let's call that. Done guys. So same way for the product name, open and close curly brace, where you will tell item dot name, so which means it will take your product name. Perfect. So under this alt we need a unique name, guys, so you need to just paste the same thing. Set guys, and now let's use a link, link link. Perfect. Two. So let's leave right now blank, guys. So we will be seeing that how to view the product in next video. So we are going to just link the product over here and just leave it blank, guys. So yep. And now let's show product list into our div tag. Save. And now guys, let's go top and import all which we have missed. So let's import that. I mean define it. Use effect, your use state, and okay. So yep guys, so let's execute the output. Get back. Link is not defined. Let's define that. Go top. Under React Router DOM, you're going to define the link. Save. Let's go to collections first. We can see errors called set loading is assigned but never used. So that is coming under view product. So we have to use the set loading. So let's get back. And this loading, set loading, we have to use after showing the product. Okay, so let's fix that also, guys, and make it to false. Save. Let's get back. Refresh. Okay, category is not used, no problem. React Hues effect is missing. Okay, so this is missing, guys. So let's copy this and get back. So this one, copy it and paste that in your array. Give comma and just separate them. So under your use effect, okay, set, refresh once again and see. Cool. So guys, we'll be using category. So first let's click on this mobile. So under mobile we have two products. We are getting the PI fetch products mobile, that is 404. I think this route is not calling correctly. So which route? This route. So let's get back to our React app, fetch products. Let's copy this and get back to our Laravel application. Let's go to our api.php. You can see it's fetch product. So you need to add that as extra. Okay, so fetch products, save. And let's try guys now. Go to collections, refresh once. Okay, let's click on mobile. Perfect. So guys, you can see that data has come and each child must have a key. So we are getting this warning. Let's fix this. So go to your view products, move below. Just give key is equal to open close curly brace. Copy this. Add all the X values, save, and you will not face that error. Refresh guys. And yep, perfect. So guys, instead of this category and this, the category name we want to show. So this one, okay. So collections and your mobile. So under mobile, we have this data. So guys, now for that, you need to you're going to use this category, which is not assigned. Okay, which is never used. Let's get back and go top. Now let's use this category. Come back below over here. Call that open and close category dot name. Okay, save and make this to collections. Okay, save it. Now guys, let's get back. Perfect. So you can see guys that collection mobile, and let's get back to collections. So let's go under men's fashion, click. Okay, so there is no product guys. So this men's fashion doesn't have a product guys. So as we can see that in our products table, we are having only for category one, that is mobile, and for men's fashion, we don't have the products guys. So guys, let's write the condition to show that products not available for men's fashion. So let's get back to our React app. So let's go top guys. Here is our product. So we need to find the product first. So what product? That is the length of the product. So let's create one variable with the product count is equal to your product dot length length. Okay. So this will provide all the product total count. Okay. So with this help of count, we are going to check that if the product at least one is there, means it will show that product is available. So inside our else condition of loading, give if product count, let's control X, one step forward, else, open and close. Let's copy the variable show product list is equal to and paste your div guys. So let me just copy from here. Let's paste and the div. Let's remove this. We don't require key ID 12. Give a h4 tag. No product available for the men's category. So you can just take this and paste, save guys, and now let's see the output. So let's get back. Perfect. So we are under men's fashion. You can see no product available. Let's go to heading. Okay, let's refresh guys. So yep, let's go to collections, click on mobiles. Perfect. So mobile data has come guys. Let's go back to our collections and click on men's fashion. Here you can see that no product available for men's fashion. Okay. So guys, in this video, we have completed how to view our product data using category list. Okay. So guys, thank you for watching this video, and let's continue next video how to view this product detail. Okay, so when we click on this, Redmi Slug will be called like this, and then it will view the product. So guys, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe, like and share.